days of old, I meditated on all thy works, and I pondered on the creations of thy hand. I stretched forth my hands as deep, my soul thirsted after thee like a waterless land. Quickly hear me, O Lord, my spirit hath made to the way. Turn not away thy face from me, lest I be like them that are damned to the pit. Cause me to hear thy mercy in the morning, for in thee have I put my hope. Cause me to know, O Lord, the way wherein I should walk, for unto thee have I lifted up my soul. Rescue me from my enemies, O Lord, unto thee have I fled for refuge. Teach me to do thy will, for thou art my God. Thy good spirit shall lead me in the land of uprightness, for thy namesake, O Lord, shall thou deliver me. In thy righteousness shall thou hear my soul out of affliction, and in thy mercy shall thou utterly destroy my enemies. For thou hast cut off all of them that afflict my soul, for I am thy servant. O Lord, give me ear to my supplication, and enter into judgment with thy servant. O Lord, give ear to my supplication, and enter not into judgment with thy servant. Thy good spirit shall lead me in the land of uprightness. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, both now and ever, and to the ages of ages. Amen. Alleluia, 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 glory to the King of God. Alleluia, 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 glory to the King of God. Alleluia, 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 glory to the King of God. O our God and our Lord, glory to thee.
In peace let us pray to the Lord. For the peace from above and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord. For the peace of the whole world, the good estate of the holy churches of God, and for the union of all men, let us pray to the Lord. For this holy house, and for those who enter with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord. For our Father, Metropolitan Joseph, the venerable priesthood, the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord. For Metropolitan Paul, Archbishop John, for their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the Lord. For the President of the United States and all civil authorities, and for our armed forces everywhere, especially Peter, Ronnie, Andrew, Joshua, Connor, Skyler, Benjamin, Thaddeus, and Adam, let us pray to the Lord. For this city, for every city and land, and for the faithful who dwell therein, for healthful seasons, for abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord. For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and their salvation, and especially for those suffering for the faith, let us pray to the Lord. For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and need, help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. Calling to remembrance are all holy, immaculate, most blessed, glorious Lady Theotokos, and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
For unto thee are due all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Thanks to the Lord. save us, have mercy upon us. Keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All in your remembrance are all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious. Ourselves and each other, and our whole life unto Christ our God.
Yeah.
save us, have mercy upon us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All in your remembrance are all holy Immaculate, most blessed and glorious, keep their souls never in with all the saints, let us commit ourselves and each other and our whole life unto you, Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
Lord, blessed is thy name, and glorified is thy kingdom, of the Father, of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Crown of thorns that glittered on him, and they began to salute him.
Hail, King of the Jews! And they struck his head with a reed and spat upon him. And they knelt down in homage to him. And when they had mocked him, they stripped him of the purple cloak and put his own clothes on him. And they led him out to crucify him. And they compelled a passerby, Simon of Cyrene, who was coming in from the country, the father of Alexander and Rufus, to carry the cross of Jesus. And they brought Jesus to a place called Golgotha, which means the place of the skull. And they offered him wine mingled with myrrh, but he did not take it. And they crucified him. And dividing his garments among them, casting lots for them to decide what each should take. And it was the third hour when they crucified him. And the inscription of the charge against him read, "The King of the Jews." And with them they crucified two robbers, one on his right and one on his left. And the scripture was fulfilled, which says, "He was reckoned with the transgressors." And those who passed by were deriding him, wagging their heads, saying, "Aha, you who would destroy the temple and build it in 3 days, save yourself and come down from the cross." So also the chief priests mocked him to one another with the scribes, saying, "He saved others, he cannot save himself. Let the Christ, the King of Israel, come down from the cross, that we may see and
Christians, send down upon us thy rich mercies, through the intercessions of our all-immaculate patriarch and ever-Virgin Mary, by the might of the precious and life-giving cross, by the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, at the supplications of thy honorable glorious prophet, Warner Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, all-lovable apostles, Peter and Paul, and of all thy holy apostles, of our fathers among the saints, the great hierarchs, ecumenical teachers, especially those of the Fourth Ecumenical Council, whose memory we commemorate today, Basil the Great, Gregory the Theologian, and John Chrysostom, Athanasios, Cyril, and John the Merciful, Patriarchs of Alexandria, Nicholas of Myra, Spiridon of Prometheus, Nectarius of Pentapolis, the wonder workers of our fathers among the saints, Tikhon, Patriarch of Moscow, Raphael, Bishop of Brooklyn, of the holy, glorious, great martyrs, George the Trophy-Dare, Demetrius the Murder-Streamer, Theodore the Soldier, Theodore the General, and Minas the wonder worker of the Hiram Martyrs, Ignatius the God-Bearer of Antioch, Pompos, Eleutherios, of the holy, glorious, great women martyrs, Thecla, Barbara, Anastasia, Catherine, Kiriaki, Fatini, Marina, Breska, Renegrini, of the holy, glorious, right, victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers who shone in the ascetic life, St. Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of the higher martyr, Epiphanius, and his 10 disciples, of the 15,000 martyrs of Pisidia, who indeed through St. Marina, whose memory we celebrate today, and of all thy saints, we beseech thee, O most merciful Lord, hearken unto the petitions of us sinners, who make their supplications unto thee, have mercy upon us.
Monophysitism overemphasized the divine nature of Christ at the expense of the human. The the Fourth Ecumenical Council condemn monophysitism and proclaim that Christ has two complete natures, the divine and human, as defined by previous councils. These two natures function as equally perfect without confusion, and are neither divided nor separate. The Fathers declared that at no time did they undergo any change. By the intercession of thy saints, O Christ God, have mercy on us. Amen.
save us, have mercy upon us. Keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All in your remembrance are all holy, immaculate, most blessed and glorious, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto you, Christ our God.
To thee, O Lord.
For all the powers of heaven praise thee, and unto thee they ascribe glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
For the world that
Fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Joseph, the venerable priesthood, the diaconate in Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For Metropolitan Paul and Archbishop John, for their quick release from captivity and safe return, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the President of the United States and all civil authorities, and for armed forces everywhere, especially Peter, Ronnie, Andrew, Joshua, Connor, Skyler, Benjamin, Thaddeus, and Adam, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this city, for every city and land, and for the faithful who dwell therein, for healthful seasons, abundance of the fruits of the earth, and for peaceful times, let us pray to the Lord. For travelers by sea, by land, and by air, for the sick and the suffering, for captives and their salvation, and especially for those suffering for the faith, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and need, help us, save us, have mercy on us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace. All in remembrance are all holy, immaculate, most blessed, glorious, Lady, faithful, most ever virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
Unto thee, O Lord, all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
King is glory. the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, O God, ever and unto the ages of ages. Amen.
Holy, begotten Son, and immortal Word of God, who for our salvation this will to be incarnate, of the Holy Theotokos, was and ever Virgin Mary, who without change didst become man, and was crucified of Christ our God, traveling down death by death, who art one of the Holy Trinity, glorified with the Father and the Holy Spirit, save us.
Again and again in peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and keep us, O God, by thy grace.
Lord, have mercy.
All of you, Reverend Carl, Holy Magdalene, most blessed and glorious, we be there for the Savior. All of us saints, let us commend ourselves and each other and our whole life unto you. Praise our God.
Lord, thou art a good God, and lovest mankind, and to thee we ascribe glory, the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
the Holy Spirit, now and unto ages of ages.
Themselves to good deeds. These are excellent and profitable to men, but avoid stupid controversies, genealogies, dissensions, and quarrels over the law, for they are unprofitable and futile. As for a man who is factious, after admonishing him once or twice, have nothing more to do with him. Like knowing that such a person is perverted and sinful, he is self-condemned. When I send Artemas or Tychicus to you, do your best to come to me at Nicopolis, for I have decided to spend the winter there. Do your best to speed Zenas the lawyer and Apollos on their way. See that they lack nothing. And let our people learn to apply themselves to good deeds, so as to help cases of urgent need and not to be unfruitful. All who are with me send greetings to you. Greet those who love us in the faith. Grace be with you all. Amen.
Peace be with you, God, and you live.
You are the light of the world. A A city set on a hill cannot be hid, nor do men light a lamp and put it under a bushel, but on a stand, and it gives light to all in the house. Let your light so shine before men that they may see your good works and give glory to your Father who is in heaven. Think not that I have come to abolish the law and the prophets. I have come not to abolish them, but to fulfill them. For truly I say to you, till heaven and earth pass away, not an iota, not a dot will pass from the law until all is accomplished. Whoever then relaxes one of the least of these commandments and teaches men so shall be called least in the kingdom of heaven. But he who does them and teaches them shall be called great in the kingdom of heaven.
Pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, one God. Amen. Something happened yesterday that deserves our attention. I'm not referring to anything bad. I'm referring to something that is quite joyful, and yet at the same time does require our attention. Two little ones were received into the kingdom of God through the sacrament of baptism. And each of these little ones also received the gift of grace of the Holy Spirit. That's a very beautiful thing. It's a very wonderful thing. And why this becomes very important to each of us is not just because of our joy, but because there is a requirement for us to help these little ones and all the other little ones, and actually any of us who have been little ones, to fulfill that spiritual gift that they have received at the hands of the priest, the laying on of those hands, and the gift of the Holy Spirit. And so Jesus tells us to let our light shine. When the light of the Word or the lamp is used in the New Testament, it has to do with enlightenment, consciousness, and being awake. And we're to help. We're to help in that. The woman with the lost coin lights a lamp, and as she looks for it, she will find it. Think also of the 10 virgins and their lamps that waiting for the bridegroom, and the warning to stay awake. And so, we must encourage, we must work, we must do everything we can to help these little ones and all the little ones. Stay awake, because you know not the day or the hour when the bridegroom will come. How about the one where Jesus said, the eye is the lamp of the body, and if the light in you is darkness, how great is that darkness? The word light, enlightenment, has the word light right in the middle of it. Spirituality is one thing. One thing alone. It is waking up. And it is part of our job, one with another. But I draw attention, especially this morning, to those who were baptized yesterday, that we help them become spiritual and waking up. Because spirituality is waking up, is being conscious. It's gaining and having clarity of vision of God, of His kingdom, and every right and good thing that is required of us. In this gospel, Jesus tells us that the light is shining already right inside of us. Those little ones can't even talk yet, and yet within them, the light of spirituality is there. They have what they need. But our job is to help them keep the bushel from covering that light up, and to encourage that light, that it might become something real, something revealed to the world in which they live. Just as Jesus tells us that the light is shining already inside of us. You notice he doesn't say to the apostles, go get a light. Go get a light that you do not have. Or even to go light the lamp inside. He says, let it shine. You don't need to go find it. You don't need to go get a lighter. It's there. But But he says, let it shine. Uncover it. Uncover it. Take the bushel off and let it shine. Now this is where it gets hard. This is where it gets difficult. Because the problem isn't something. Oftentimes is covering it up. Oftentimes there's some kind of a bushel that's covering that light for all of us. And so the spiritual path is a search for whatever there is in us that is covering up that light. And that's where that work of spirituality comes to bear. Spirituality is becoming aware of the truth and embracing it and living it. That light, remember, is already shining inside. Seeing what hides it though, spirituality then becomes that work. In fact, what we see is that the life is Christ that is already there. They receive Jesus Christ. They are brought into union with Jesus Christ. And now, they need help. I need help. And I guess a few of us might also join me in that. But that light of Christ might shine forth. And that's what we do. That is how spirituality is expressed to the world. You know, it's many times scandalous. How we see that Jesus is identified so completely with people in this world to whom we would turn our backs, to whom we might drive by on the street and just ignore and find them unsavory, maybe not worth our time. And so completely, he tells us, you know, in certain terms, various places in the scripture. You give them water, you're giving water to me. You give them food, you're giving food for me, to me. You give them clothes, it's like you're giving clothes to me. You look carefully and see how you react. Not all the time, maybe, but how we react sometimes to the next homeless person we see or we meet, or the next door neighbor you have grown not to like over the years for whatever reason. You know, we really don't require much of a reason to dislike anybody, do we? You just do. Maybe you got the only answer. Why do you do that? Because I can. We can't. Or how about the person in the pew grows down that maybe you argued with a couple months ago, or maybe you just have some kind of grudge, something, and that's not hard to find either. What about that? What happens to you within? What does it feel like? If you want to turn away and you want to pretend that they do not exist, it is important that you see that something is wrong. There's a bushel covering this light at that moment of true spirituality. To see the problem is the first step to solving it. Right? That's what we say. Whatever the source of that aversive feeling is, that's the problem. And that is the something. That is the something that covers your life. Learn how to draw whatever that is. You know, maybe sometimes it takes a while to drop it. But at least get started. At least get started to live a clear life. A truthful life where you tell the truth. Yeah, you know, I just don't like the person. I don't like the way that person smells, walks, the way they are. Okay. tell the truth, and then go about the business. And just draw. You know, a lot of things are just really easy to draw if we just try. Learn how to draw whatever it is, and that is spiritual practice. That's spirituality. And when you see whatever it is, you've taken a great step towards enlightenment. You don't take a step toward enlightenment without telling the truth. Not about this person, but about this person. So give thanks for moments like that. They're painful, but they're revealing. And you have the spirituality. Without you cannot have spirituality. No spirituality if you do not tell the truth about you. Now it's very easy to tell the truth about me or your neighbor. Not so easy to tell the truth about yourself. So drop that which is repulsive. The things that you've been taught to have, wake up to the truth. That is Christ you are seeing, and that is spiritual life. There was a wonderful poem by the poet Hale Gibran, where he wrote, "I have learned silence from the talkative. I have learned toleration from the intolerant, and kindness from the unkind. Yet, strange, I am ungrateful to those teachers." Guess what? The talkative one is us. The intolerant one is us. The unkind one is us. And it's important for us to meet these negative feelings with understanding and truth. And they will vanish if we tell the truth. They will vanish. Give thanks. You see, now, as I mentioned earlier, it's painful. Who wants to see those things about oneself? Go run and hide. That only makes things worse by driving them back deeper within ourselves. So I say to you this morning, embrace, accept, understand, and all of that will vanish with time. And I want you to remember one thing. There's one truth I want you to take away from you. We project onto others what we do, what we do not know about ourselves. If we are thinking ugly, smelly, no good, then that is what we are seeing in ourselves in some way. It's good to know. It is something that we didn't know about ourselves. And so now we can see and understand it. Now we can learn to drop it. And if we have seen the light in us, then we will see the light in others. And if the warmth of love and compassion come over us in the presence of people that we meet everywhere, then it is a sign that the light is shining in us. And we have seen it. And if we are able to allow that same compassion to rise, when we recognize our own weakness, then we have something that is very sweet. We have helped to bring the very fragrance of paradise into the world. And that's a beautiful thing. And in so doing, as our loved ones, and now I do it not just for the children, but I hope the person to your left and your right are also your loved ones this morning. That our loved ones carry with them as well that sweetness of Jesus that brings glory and shows glory. And that's the good word that has been prepared for us by Christ Jesus. That's what the scriptures teach in Ephesians. It's a wonderful job we have returning to my beginning conference this morning. We do have something very important to do. for those deliverance, as well as for each other. May God help us to enrich this world with that great word for the sweetness of Jesus in all that we do. And may God have mercy on us.
Help us, save us, have mercy on us. Keep us, O God, by thy grace, praise God.
That guarded always by thy mighty hand, ascribe glory unto thee, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Thank you. captivity and safe return. The Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages. For the President of the United States and all civil authorities and our armed forces everywhere, the Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
For the Orthodox service of God, especially the newly baptized Sebastian, for James, for their parents and godparents, for Chris, Kamisha, Benjamin, Serena, Joshua, Megan, for Emily, Susan, Tony, for Stephanie, Michelle, and Kelsey, for Caitlin, Laurie, Lauren, Mary, Christina, Claire, and for Taylor, that they might have mercy, health, life, salvation, vindication, pardon, and remission of sins. The Lord God, remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
For the Orthodox servants of God departed this life, especially for Joshua, for Abigail, Michael, Valentina, for Carol, Olga, Miguel, Andre, for those whom we commemorate this morning, and for all those whose lives were lost during the Turkish invasion of Cyprus, the Lord God remember them in his kingdom, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Blessed and glorious Lady Theotokos and ever Virgin Mary, other and our whole life unto Christ our God.
Thy Holy Spirit, for all things of which we know and of which we know not, and for
to stand beside the thousands of archangels and 10,000 of angels, the cherubim and the seraphim, six wings, many eyes, sort of off and born of their wings. Sing a triumph for you, shout proclaiming and sing.
Thank you.
holy churches in peace, save thee, honor, help, and length of days, and rightly dividing the word of thy truth.
And grant us with one mouth and one heart to glorify and praise that all honorable and majestic name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and up to ages of ages. Thou who sit on high as the Father, and art here invisibly present with us,
saved by thy hands, be a partner to us by the immaculate body and precious blood, and through us unto all thy people. By the grace of this Son, by the grace of
let us be attentive.
Holy things are for them.
Thank you.
with faith and love draw near.
Thank you.
have saved thy people and blessed thy inheritance.
We have seen the true light. We have received the Holy Spirit. We have found the true faith, worshiping the unified Trinity, who has saved us.
Always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
intercessions of his own immaculate and all blameless Holy Mother, by the might of the precious and life-giving cross, by the protection of the honorable bodiless powers of heaven, at the supplication of the honorable glorious prophet, forerunner, and Baptist John, of the holy, glorious, and all laudable apostles, of our father among the saints, John Chrysostom, Archbishop of Constantinople, whose divine liturgy we have now celebrated, of the holy, glorious, and might victorious martyrs, of our venerable and God-bearing fathers, especially the 630 of the Fourth Ecumenical Council, whom we commemorate today, of Saint Barnabas, the patron and protector of this holy community, of the holy and righteous ancestors of God, Joachim and Anna, of the Hiera martyr Athenogenes, the bishop of Heracleopolis, and his 10 disciples, and the 15,000 martyrs of Pisidia who believed in Christ through Saint Marina, whose memory we celebrate today, and of all the saints. Have mercy upon us and save us, for as much as he is good and loves us most kind. Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ our God, have mercy on us and save us.
Amen.
We will now do the memorial prayers for our departed loved ones who have passed away during the month of July. Ask for those who are remembering them to come forward at this time. Our God, always, now, and ever, and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Holy God, holy, mighty, holy, immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy, mighty, holy, immortal, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy, mighty, holy, immortal, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Amen. Oh, Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. Lord, cleanse us from our sins. Master, pardon our iniquities. Holy God, visit any of our infirmities for thy name's sake. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen. By thy Spirit, still the righteous be perfect. Give rest to his soul, as a gentle Savior. And preserve it in the blessedness which is with thee,
Jess, Maria, Father Peter, Elma, Robert, Wade, Sr., Andrew, Hope, Denise, Louisa, Alfonso, Hannah, Mila, George, Richard, Eugene, Helen, Archimandra, Dion, Archpriest Nikolai, John, Father Gordon, Albert, Virginia, Scott, Arnie, Metropolitan Antonio, Metropolitan Paul, Miguel, Michael, Joshua, Abigail, Andre, Valentina. Let us remember our brothers and sisters who lost their lives during the 1974 Turkish invasion of Cyprus, and may we keep those who are still suffering in our prayers. And all those departed this life, that thou wilt pardon their retransgression, both voluntary and involuntary.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
And the Lord God will establish their souls where the just repose, the mercies of God, the kingdom of heaven, and remission of their sins. Let us ask of Christ, our immortal King and our God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Have mercy.
O God of spirits and of all flesh, who has trampled down death and made powerless the devil and given life to thy world, do thou, the same Lord, give rest to the soul of thy departed servants. Elias, Maria, the priest Peter, Thelma, Robert, Queen, Senior, Andrew, Hope, Denise, Louisa, Alfonso, Manikila, for George, Richard, Eugene, Helen, Archimandre, Juan, for Archpriest Nikolai, for John, for the priest court, Albert, Virginia, Scott, Arnie, Metropolitan Antonio, for the Metropolitan Paul, and for those Greeks killed during the Turkish invasion, for Miguel, Michael, Joshua, Abigail, Andre, Valentina, in a place of ripeness, a place of virtue, a place of repose, let all sickness, sorrow, and sighing fled away. Pardon every sin which they have committed, whether by word or deed or thought, for thou art good and lovest mankind. For there is no man who liveth and sinneth not, and thou only art without sin, and thy righteousness is to all eternity, and thy law is true. For thou art the resurrection and the life, and the repose of thy departed servants, O Christ our God. And unto thee do we ascribe glory, together with thy Father who is everlasting, that all holy good and life-giving Spirit now and ever and unto ages of ages.
Amen.
Wisdom, O blessed Theotokos, who art most merciful, save us.
Thank you.
Jesus. He missed it. He missed it. Everything's, I think we have, do we have one or two other announcements? Is there anything that was, I thought there was. I must have been dreaming. Welcome to my world. Okay, well, take a look at your bulletin, and welcome all those visiting this morning. Please join us for coffee hour. Goodies and coffee are free. Can't be dead. And we'd like to meet you all. And welcome now to come forward to venerate the Holy Cross.
Thank you.